Hello, YouTube. This video is a follow-up from the previous videos that I've made regarding Pinkchu, Tectone, Zizix Prime, and we have some introductions here, but I'm not going to mention them other than to say that I've read the Google Doc. I'm not going to, you know, use that on stream because I have a very credible source to know that even though maybe some of those things happened, they didn't happen in the way that they were outlined, and it wasn't malicious, and that it was in good faith. You know, mistakes were made, obviously. This does not pertain to the Tectone situation, and therefore, although, you know, it is two people that had a disagreement, I'm not going to bring them up, and partly because of all of the dirt that's been flung Pinkchu's way, which I think has been disingenuous. And that includes Zizix Prime, who went on his stream today and cleared things up, said that he got it from some other source and that he didn't understand how people, because he was blocked, you know, perceived that what he presented on Twitter, which was basically a no context 30-second video of text messages saying that I want to sue you, and he didn't provide anything else to, you know, conveniently say that that wouldn't be like something that we would think was his. Apparently it was somebody else that sent him something, whatever else. He knew that he was wrong. He apologized for it, you know, but all of that slander, all that discreditness, all these things that, you know, people do when it comes to women or men who are trying to get their truths out, it happened and can't take it back. So I acknowledge that he tried to apologize. So today we're going to watch another video that encapsulates a lot of this stuff. So we're going to react to it and see what it's all about. It's only about 2 minutes, and it's from a content creator called Inki, I-N-K-I, all capitalized, and it seems like it's performing pretty well. So let's dig in here, and I'm just going to react to it normally, I guess would be the right term here.
Developments in the drama between Tectone and Pink. Following the recent developments in the drama between Tectone and Pink, with Pink releasing tweets that
Okay, so a lot of this stuff we haven't talked about actually, contextually, right? Essentially, this was stuff that was exchanged on Discord, and I guess this was shared on other places, but it says, Pinkchu, please stop talking about me on stream. Stop lying. I broke up with you because I suspected you cheated on me. Stop taking pot shots at me on stream. You know, the next day we got back together, I broke up with you on July 23rd. Didn't want to be your friends with benefits on July 26th. And he is not lying to protect me. He's lying because he doesn't want Sophie to know we were still together. I was told by someone else he told her the same lie.
Exposed Tectone for lying about their breakup date on stream along with other...
Okay, so this was probably the biggest egregious instance. You have to understand the context of this particular drama. You have to understand how Tectone works to begin with, to understand why he would use somebody else to try to make him look better in a certain situation, because this is what Tectone has done time and time again. Whenever there's a controversy, whether it be regarding MTashed or Hex Shoes, or if it has to deal with something else, he'll get his roommates, he'll get his content creator friends to either willingly or maliciously or, you know, subjectively whatever the case may be, to make content or to defend him. And in this case, apparently, there's some admittance here. We both know how treated me and your ex-wife. You had her sign an NDA to keep her quiet about the abuse, then told me to specifically go over the car clip on stream and lie to me and said it was the day you caught her cheating. But I found out later it was a lie. Just like your many lies, you used me and manipulated me to make you look like a victim when she was the victim all along. She didn't even know Cruz till a month later. As shown here, this is how he treated both of us. Our friends saw it, my family saw it, and I'm glad I'm out. And apparently this shows some receipts as to when this person that has been admitted to cheating on or was the issue for a lot of the controversy. So he treated her badly even before she potentially cheated, which was what his excuse was. which is the ultimate problem. Always uses the worst case scenario, and then makes this, you know, whatever excuse can be convenient for him to get sympathy. It's a tactic. It's used often in relationships. It's used often in content creation. And I'm going to call it out. I've already called it out. I'm going to continue to call it out. It's not right. And no one should be in this particular instance to where they have to feel like they owe something to somebody or, you know, in debt to somebody. And listen, you know, I'm sure their marriage was already rocky if at this point, potentially, you know, presumably. So there was probably a lot of tension and stuff like that. Again, why do you stream these kind of things? Why do you stream these interactions? What's the, you know, what is the need for both people in the house to be a streamer? Both, you know, Ephraim was a streamer at the time. His last roommate, Pinkchu, was a streamer at the time. Sophie is a streamer at the time. What is this incessant need to all be streamers when in reality, you know, just do what you do best. Play gacha games and talk about the gacha community. At least in that lane, it's not personal. But no, you want to make excuses. You want to act like you're better than you are, which you're not. And that's okay because it's human. But at the same time, I'm going to call you out. Here we go.
About their breakup date on stream along.
This is only the beginning. I don't want him to have the narrative that things were good when they weren't. I and start lying and giving false dates to spin things. I gain nothing from going after this guy. But soon I'll come out with everything when the time is right. We just don't want him to make any more victims. Wow, that's pretty profound.
Along with other lies we covered in the previous video, many of his friends, mods, and orbiters spoke out.
Okay, well, so we have, oh, and I want to mention this individual in the center here, the provocative lady who's having a great pose. She's the one that's the Google Doc is about that I read, which I'm not going to, you know, use here as a way to leverage or to give other people sides or sympathy, because although it is credible to some degree, like the events apparently have been at least verified. I have a very credible source to say that it wasn't malicious and it was unfortunate and it was a mistake in some cases. So I'm going to leave it at that. And this is obviously his roommate, which he didn't even use the Golden Brother on. I don't understand that. I mean, LaRoe is like the only person Tekton has never nepotized. And maybe that makes him his truest friend. I don't know.
About the situation. Most defended Tekton, including his current head mod, who lives with him, and even Z Isaacs, who was previously banned from an OTK show and Emiru's stream for discussing her deepfakes.
I didn't know that. Okay, interesting.
Z Isaacs spoke about the situation on his stream and attacked Pink. Novaru?
Oh, the guy is calling him Zizix. Okay, so yeah, okay, we do know about Zizix.
Pink's former roommate, who had a falling out with her before Pink started dating Tekton, was seen in Zizix's chat, revealing that she would be releasing a full document about Pink and her ex-boyfriend cheating with Pink. However, the 12-page document Novaru posted ended up making her look worse than Pink. Zizix later posted a tweet he received that allegedly showed Pink threatening to sue people if they didn't stop talking about her. Pink quickly responded, exposing Zizix by proving the screenshot was fake and that she never made such threats.
This is a fake video, by the way. This is a fake video, by the way.
Zizites then issued an apology on Twitter, admitting he was baited. Meanwhile, Canute added more fuel to the fire by leaking Tekton relationship, essentially confirming that he is dating Sophia. Here's the clip.
It was Tekton's girlfriend there.
If you want to talk about this with people and get more detailed info, join the linked Discord community server in the description.
Okay, so I don't recommend you go to any Discord, obviously. I don't even recommend you go to mine, although you can go to mine, I guess. Because I can only really hold myself accountable. I can't hold anybody else's Discord accountable. But because I am using this individual's video, you know, do obviously come here, give Inky some support, subscribe, like, comment. I already have. I got permission to react to this content from the man or the person or they themselves. So that's where we're at. So at this point in time, we're going to stop covering this But if there's any new relevant information regarding Pink Chew and Tectone, and if it gets, you know, to the degree that there's some legal things here, and if it's really, you know, potentially illegal, then I'll stop talking about it and let the court process or whatever else take its course. Although I'm not assuming or trying to insinuate that's the case. Obviously, we see what is being said here on Pink Chew's defense, and there was a lot of people trying to discredit. And obviously, Zig's Prime looks like an ass, and a lot of people look like an ass, and that's just par of the course for the Tectone community. So my name is Zig. If you like this comment, like, subscribe, we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.